Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConTalk. Today, let's talk about flip chip attach. Flip chip attach process is to attach die with bumps by flipping. And it is like combining die attach and wire bonding process. This process starts with sewn die with bumps. Die is flipped means die pad with bumps will face down and attach on package substrate. There are two major differences between flip chip attach and conventional die attach. One is die placement accuracy. It is very important for flip chip die attach process because tiny bump on die should be located at exact location of bond pad or package substrate to make good electrical connection. But for conventional die attach, wire bonding still can make good electrical connection, even though there are some misplacement. By the way, it will not work for optical sensors, which requires accurate optical alignment. Second, flip chip attach process need underfill process afterward, because CT mismatch between die and package substrate causes mechanical stress on bumps, then break bumps. So, underfill is required for flip chip attach to protect bumps from this mechanical stress. So, process flow is flux dipping or dispensing, flip chip attaching, reflow and flux cleaning, underfill dispensing and curing. Bumps can be solder bump or capillary bump. Actually, this process flow is about mass reflow, which is one of processes of flip chip attach. There are three major processes for flip chip attach: mass reflow, thermal compression bonding, and laser assist bonding. The most popular one is mass reflow. After flip chip attach, this process uses reflow to make electrical interconnection. Next one is TCNCP, thermal compression with NCP. Its process flow is NCP dispensing, TC bonding, NCP cure. As you can see, there are two major differences in TCNCP compared to mass reflow. One is TCNCP uses thermal compression bonding instead of reflow to make electrical interconnection. Thermal compression bonding means it uses heat and compression force. It also uses NCP, non-conductive paste, instead of underfill, and dispense before TC bonding. Typically, this process is for capillary bump with fine bump pitch, like less than 150 micrometers, and requires dedicated machine, which is different with conventional flip chip attach machine. And TCNCP machine requires better die placement accuracy than conventional flip chip attach, because there is no reflow process with self-alignment by solder bump, which can compensate die placement error. The last one is LAB, laser assist bonding. It uses laser to make connection between bump and package substrate. It uses infrared laser with 980 nanometer. It is the best solution for low-k devices because it can focus IR laser at bump interconnection and minimize thermal stress for package. But it requires dedicated machine with optic system. Its process flow is flux dipping or dispensing, flip chip attached by IR laser, flux cleaning, underfill dispensing, and cure. In summary, mass reflow is the most popular process with good UPH, unit per hour productivity, because it reflows whole strip of package substrate at one time. It means whole package is exposed for reflow and can get thermal damage if devices are sensitive to heat. It is good for coarse bump pitch application over 150 micrometers. TCNCP is good for fine bump pitch application less than 150 micrometers with better die placement accuracy. But it attaches die one by one, so UPH is lower than mass reflow, and it also requires dedicated machine. LAB is good for low-k devices which are sensitive to thermal stress. It applies IR laser for bump connection. Process is done for block, part of package substrate strip with multiple unit. But it also requires dedicated machine with optics system. This is brief introduction to flip chip die attach process. I hope this can help to understand basic flip chip attach process. Have a nice day and see you again soon. Bye bye.